In this mini clip, we will be discussing common math mistakes to avoid. Here we have a question. It reads, if cos of x is equal to 1, then does x equal 1 divided by cos? This statement is not true. This is a common mistake that is made by students at the high school level. Cos, or any other trigonometric function such as tan or sine, has no meaning on its own, just like how it's written here in the denominator. Cos on its own has no meaning. We always need to find the cosine of an angle, which is why we need a number or a variable following this trigonometric function. Such as here, we have cos of some angle, and in this case, it is represented by the variable x. In other words, cosine always needs an argument. You might be wondering then, how would we solve for x if cos of x is equal to 1? Well, what this means is that we need to find a value for x such that once we take the cosine of this value, we will get 1. So in order to get a better idea of what it is we need to do, let's take a look at the graph for cosine. Hopefully we are all familiar with the graph of cos x. We have cos x is equal to 1. This means we need to find all our values of x such that once we take the cos of this value, we have our y value equal to 1. So here you'll notice that our y value is equal to 1, as well as here, and as well as here. Now we need to find the x values when this occurs. So we'll notice x equals 0 here, x is equal to 2 pi here, and x is equal to 4 pi here. Because the cosine function is periodic, this means that this graph will continue in both the left and right directions. Therefore, if we have cos of x equal to 1, we know that our x values have to equal 0. They could equal plus 2 pi, or continuing in the negative direction, it will also equal negative 2 pi. So we have plus or minus 2 pi, or plus or minus 4 pi. And we keep going so on and so forth. So these are all the possible values for x.